Hey, it's been a tough time with news lately. We simply don't see a lot of information about future Apple products, and it's usually something very short and not very particular. In my previous video, I've been talking about all the Macs we can expect next year. But this time, I want to focus on one of the models specifically, the next Mac Mini. Hi friends, and welcome to Digital Marketing Channel. My name is Marco, and this is your dose of Apple news, leaked information, rumors, and opinions. Make sure you subscribe, leave a comment below, hit the like button, and don't forget to enable all notifications soon as the next video. This video has been sponsored by MOFT. Let me quickly introduce you to their MacBook carry sleeve and stand. Now, this is my third product review from good folks of MOFT. This accessory comes in three different sizes, 13-inch, 13.3, and 16, also available in various colors, the Night Black, Oxford Blue, and Sienna Brown. Once you open it, it has two compartments. Once closed, the sleeve is secured by magnetic closure. This MOFT baby is scratch and water resistant. Beside being a carry sleeve and laptop basic protection, you can set it in two different angles, 15 degrees and 25, which will help you feel more comfortable while working longer hours. You can check it out in the link in the description or in pinned comment. We have been expecting Mac Mini all throughout this year, but at the end, it didn't happen. And if this situation continues, we will likely not see it yet. Just a few months ago, Mark Gurman from Bloomberg gave us a clue that the new Apple Silicon MacBooks will be revealed, while redesigned Mac Mini may end up delayed. Other leaks reveal how the introduction of the new Mac Mini can interfere with sales of other similar products. Without getting deeply into the story, I can agree on one thing. Since I doubt its price will go over $1,200, with the power which has been anticipated, which we will talk in details right now, it is possible it could make a mess in decision making, and some potential customers may opt for the mini desktop just because of the value for the money? Doesn't make sense. Recently, we got a report or leak that suggests how the upcoming iteration of the Mac Mini could end up powered by the M1 Pro and or the M1 Max processor. While this is not impossible, I already explained why this is not something that I'm keen to believe. Don't get me wrong, I would love it. But at the same time, we are already expecting the M2 chip, which should be at the core of the 2022 MacBook Air. This laptop may be released somewhere in the middle of the next year or later, which can equally happen to the Mac Mini. As I've explained in my previous video, it is likely that for the MacBook Air, Apple will use the same strategy as with 2021 MacBook Pro lineup, keeping the old design with previous gen chip while including the newer updated version. If you observe things like this, you would probably respond like, hey, this year MacBook Pro showcased the M1 Pro and M1 Max as successors of the M1 of their predecessor. Yeah, that's true. Sadly, Mac Mini is not, and it has never been considered as a Pro device with all its design. Heck, I'm even eager to believe that the next Mac Pro could easily have mini designation, since we are expecting much smaller casing than its Intel-based version. Personally, to me, the Mac Mini, although with the extremely capable M1 processor, is still a mainstream desktop device, similarly to 2021 iMac. With that in mind, it would make more sense that Apple keeps the old design with the M1 for entry-level Mac Mini, while refresh model could arrive with the M2. I'm not saying I couldn't be wrong, but if Apple keeps the old design of the MacBook Air, similar scenario can take place with the Mac Mini product line. Let's be realistic. Who says Apple wouldn't dump the old designs all along the existing product groups next year? It's just a guessing game. As far as other details go, the new Mac Mini will come in various colors, which is now almost synonymous with Apple devices with the Air naming. More ports have been expected, including the MagSafe, but don't look forward to USB-A. If we're honest, Apple can also just replace the existing entry-level Mac Mini with the new design while keeping the M1 inside. After all, visual signature of 2020 Mini desktop is more than 8 years old, so you can easily call it the obsolete. What do you think? Which chip will power the next Mac Mini? Please answer in the comment section below. That's all. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the thumbs up and turn on notifications. Thank you so much for watching this The Mocking Channel. My name is Marco. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.